Welcome back. Hi. How you doing? My son's napping right now. I can't guarantee he's gonna stay asleep during the whole of this video. I'm gonna try and get it done. As you can tell by the title, we're doing a random number color makeup challenge. Technically, it's a random number challenge, but whatever. And today we're doing it with the Lorac Mega Pro 4. I recently broke this palette out again and used it, and I remember it being better. It could be old. It could be. But I remember liking it more than how I liked it when I used it recently. So I thought I would break it out for this video. It's got a lot of color options, very nice selection, so this should be interesting. Regardless of how I feel about the palette, it should come out interesting. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to, so there's 16 matte shadows and 16 shimmer shadows. What I want to do is I'm going to pick 5 eyeshadows. I'm gonna do 3 mattes and 3 shimmer, or 3 mattes and 2 shimmers. So I've got my numbers here. I've got 1 through 16. I'm gonna just draw for the colors. And then of course I have my ABH highlighters. I have some lipsticks, some eyeliners. I went ahead and did my blush. That's the only thing we're not gonna be picking. But yeah, we're just gonna get right into it. So first we're gonna draw for eyeshadows. Okay, 13. Try to make it so you can see it. 3. And let's fold it up. And 2. So 2 is Flamingo, which is a light pink. You can't really see it on my skin. Try to build that up. 3 is Cool Taupe, which is a very light cream color. Okay, 13 is Mahogany, which is a warm, darker brown. Okay. Shimmers are 10 and 1. Foam. It's number 1. 10 is Lotus. This is unexpectedly cohesive. They're all kind of like, they all kind of have a pinky tone to them, or more cool tone anyway. Now we're gonna pick the highlighter. I'm too lazy to pull up the numbers, so anything past 12 is gonna be my choice. 16. Finally, I got to pick. Okay, I'm gonna go for this cool toned green duochrome. I will have the exact name listed down below with everything else, but I think that'll play real nicely with those pinky colors. Eyeliner's in the basket. Oh, got a tip. Interesting. This is the E.L.F. and J. Kissa eyeliner. If you'd like a dupe, Urban Decay's mainline is basically the same thing. I didn't say it'd be a cheap dupe, but it is a dupe. These are all my Fenty dupes. We got another teal. Holy crap. It's a little weird of a place to swatch, but that is Turks and Caicos. So that is my color story I'm gonna be working with. I need to go get my son. Hold on. All right, my son is now sitting in here with me. I brought some of his toys in. So if you hear any like that, I'm sorry, but it is what it is. All right, so let's get into it. I'm gonna start with Flamingo. I'm gonna put that in my crease. This is just gonna act as a transition shade. Then I'm gonna take a Mahogany, that dark brown, and I'm gonna put this on my outer corner. Hotter than balls in this room. I don't know why. Okay, now I'm gonna take Cool Taupe on my finger. I use it somewhere, right? And I'm just patting that onto my lid. Now I'm taking my eyeliner, and this is gonna go in my waterline. I'm also gonna use this as a lip liner, actually. Now, I'm going to take Lotus, that darker pink, that shimmery darker pink. I'm going to take that on a flat eyeliner brush. I'm going to take this on my lower lash line. On a different eyeliner brush, I'm going to take Foam, that light shimmery color. And I'm just gonna put that right on the inner part of my lower lash line. I'm gonna do some mascara. This is the E.L.F. Oh, I'm so sorry. The E.L.F. Lengthening Volumizing and Defining Mascara. Okay, then highlighter. Let me get my shit together. And then I'm also taking some of the under my brow bone. Then, I'm gonna take the eyeliner I used and I'm gonna line my lips real quick. I made an attempt at lip contouring. And I'm gonna take, and again, this is Turks and Caicos. The Lorac eyeshadows are pretty. But I wonder if they had come out today, like if Lorac had just started as a brand, same formula and everything, if they would have gotten as much hype as they did when they first started. The eyeshadows are pretty, they're just they're not like other eyeshadows that I've gotten used to using. I don't think I'll get rid of this palette. It's interesting to see how my taste in makeup has changed, because I remember really loving Lorac eyeshadows. I use like their highlighters, their blushes, like Lorac's got some great products, but I remember loving their eyeshadows and thinking they were like the best thing ever. And it's kind of sad because that's not the case anymore. But yeah, I guess that's that. It's sad, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Anyway, I'm gonna go take care of him, try to get, see if I can get his tummy feeling a bit better. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you have this palette, or any Lorac palettes for that matter, what do you think of the formulas? Is it still something you really enjoy? Are you not as impressed by them anymore? Talk to me in the comments. Anyway, see you next time. Bye!